Feels like God moved during that week. And maybe it's just because by Friday we're so exhausted, we're all falling over. And so the fact that you get back up again is just evidence of resurrection. But truly, truly, God moves among these children and their families and the relationships and the conversations. I found a new nickname, Pastor Moses, and here you go, is now the whiner, which is actually so unlike her. But we are working and adapting and getting to know all of these incredible, incredible children and teens. So if you would, please join me in our gathering prayer. Holy One, we bow our hearts before you this day. Strengthen us in our innermost being and dwell in our hearts through faith. May we be rooted and grounded in Christ, whose love is beyond all knowledge. Help us comprehend even the smallest part of the beautiful mystery of your grace. Grant that we may experience the fullness of your presence with us. Amen. Our kids are going to do some sharing of VBS insights.
I, of course, need my cheat sheets. Like, don't forget and get out of order. But you will have heard already that, of course, we followed Moses. And so there are lots and lots of stories about Moses. But the one thing that we learned, I'm sure you figured out already from our call to worship, is that we are to trust God. And so we hear all of these stories and each one of them, we remember that we are to trust God. And so we are going to have some of our kids come up, kids and our youth, come up and share with you the scriptures that we heard throughout the week, but also kind of what they learned, the story they heard, and what they learned. And so to start us off today, we have Claire Berger.
On Monday, we met a man named Moses. God called him to lead the Israelites out of Egypt where they were slaves. They were wandering in the desert when Pharaoh changed his mind and came after them. Through Moses, God parted the Red Sea, which provided a road to safety for the Israelites. God was with them as they journeyed through the wilderness.
And Peyton Segedy?
For your God knows exactly what you need before you ask. Moses is still wandering in the desert with the Israelites. The people are whining and complaining that they are hungry because there is no food to eat in the desert. God provides them by laying quail in the morning and manna or bread in the evening.
Michelle Berger, one of our adult staff members who has been in charge of our culture for us.
Good
from Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. For I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Also, wandering in the desert, the Israelites end up in battle with the Amalekites. Every time Moses raised his staff above his head, the Israelites started to win. But when his arms got tired and he put his arms down, the Amalekites started winning. Two of Moses' friends stood next to him and held his arms up for him when he no longer had the strength to do it himself. God also stands next to us and gives us strength when we need it.
Hello, everyone. I'm Moses, and I have been journeying over the past couple of decades with these young people on our quest, our journey to get to the promised land, our quest to find freedom. Now, I tell you, it's been an incredible journey. We have been chased not by one army, but two. First, we had anybody remember? Any of you guys remember the first army that chased us? What was it, Caitlin? Do any of you guys remember? The Egyptian army chased us, yeah. And then we got free, but it was sandy. It was boring. It was hot.
Hey, Moses, we gotta talk. It is so boring. All I see is sand and sand. There's sand in my nose. There's sand in my toes. All there is sand.
I know. It's been a long journey. We were even hungry, weren't we?
Oh, we were so hungry. I was waiting for a turtle burger. Martin.
I know. We had to get used to quail. We had to get used to quail and manna.
It's really old, really quick.
Yeah, and the water wasn't all that fresh until we prayed. Yeah, and then all of a sudden we heard hoofbeats.
Egyptians again!
Yeah, and we discovered we were being chased again by another army, the Amalekites, and so I asked Joshua, one of my best people, to get some good folks together to help us defend ourselves against the Amalekites, right? And Joshua did always, as Joshua does, what God asked of him, but he needed my help. So I had to go up on the ridge to watch the battle, and I noticed that they were losing. But when I raised my staff up, my people began to win again. And the battle went on, and it was long, wasn't it, guys? And my arm got tired. And so I would pull my arms down because they got so tired. And you know what happened? My people started to lose. They started to get hurt again. And so I needed some friends. I know you like to whine, Malachi, but will you be a friend? Can I get another friend?
As long as it's not too hard.
Yeah. Can I get another friend? Oh, Julia. Julia. She's
small but mighty.
Small but mighty indeed. All right, let's raise this up again. Can you guys help me?
Can you help me hold her hands up?
Can you help me?
Maybe just get on a step. Get on a step. There you go,
Julia. Oh. And they helped me. And they helped me, and for hours and hours as my people fought. But when we did it together, right? When we all pitched in together, it worked, didn't it? It worked. And so even though it's a little weird telling children stories of war, right? And violence, what we learn and the point that we took from it in our VBS, right? Is that we are community. We are a family. And God sometimes asks us to do really tough things, right? But when we do it together, what happens? It gets what? easier. It gets easier, yeah. And so as long as we stick together and do things together, we can help each other out and do great things, right? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, helpers. Thank you. And I think that's it, right? That's our big story this week. Well, that's one of many stories that we told.
That was day three. So day four, we have the Passover.
We did the Passover.
And so Mark Glover is going to come tell us about the Passover.
Come on up.
You're the next contestant.
Jeremiah 30:11. For I am with you and I will save you, says the Lord. Moses told us about the Israelite celebration of Passover, where they remember how God saved them from slavery in Egypt. Every year they celebrate by sitting down for a seder meal where they tell the story of how the Hebrew people got to Egypt and then Moses. God called to Moses back to Egypt to tell the Pharaoh to let the people go, but he doesn't. So God sends 10 plagues to Egypt. The 10th plague, where the angel of death passes over the Israelite soul, is when the Pharaoh changes his mind and lets the people go. So every year, the Israelites retell the story of slavery and how God delivered them for something.
And for day five, Barbara Lewis. So we followed Moses through the wilderness, through escaping, remembering battles with the Amalekites, through hunger and fear, and through all of it, most of us Israelites here, complaining. And we had our steady Moses who constantly reminded us, no matter what, to trust God. Ms. Davis is going to tell us about our statistics.
Good morning. We had a great week at Wilderness State VBS. Even though COVID forced us to rethink how we do VBS, we still had a great time. We had to figure out how we could invite the children into the church and keep them safe. We adapted and modified and masked, and I believe we accomplished the goal. The best thing about this year's VBS was we were together again to come around and show your shirts. All of our t-shirts have the handprints of the children that were in each classroom separately, but we were all together, and it really, really was awesome. Last year it was virtual and it was not the same. So thank you, Spencer and Donna. I'd like to give you some statistics from this past week that I think you'll find interesting. This year we had 57 kids registered for VBS. To show you what a huge outreach ministry that is, 72% of those children were from the community. That is the largest percentage since I've been working and helping with PBS here at this church. Eight of those students were HHH kids, so that was exciting. We had an awesome staff of volunteers and youth. We had 65 people that helped with PBS this year. 38 were youth helpers and 27 were adults. We need to thank three behind-the-scenes people who worked especially hard this week to make PBS such a success. We want to thank Ms. Amy for using her Cricut and making all of our wonderful t-shirts. We want to thank Mr. Matt for running our sound and reading our minds all week. And Mr. Bart for doing such an excellent job of cleaning up for us all week, including the litter, and even worth washing the windows in the cleaning area. Just thank Joel and I would like to thank all of the VBS staff, the children who came, and the congregation for supporting this mission. Thank you.
Yeah.
So let us go to God in prayer. And since we're a little bit more casual this morning, do any of you out there have anything that you would like lifted in prayer? Nope. Not used to doing that at the night. A little quieter. All right. Young people, anything we should lift up? Oh, I got one. Yeah. And her first name is, her first name? Lisa. So thank you for sharing answered prayer. Amen. So thank you. Anyone else have? So my family and I are going to be heading out tomorrow to Tennessee for our week off. So Kitty Jo will be holding down the fort next Sunday. And next Sunday, I will be at my Sowell family reunion. And there are many, many, many of us. My sons, my husband, my sons have met some of us, but my husband has not met any of my extended Sowell family. And there are a ton of us. We all look kind of alike. And you won't lose me, I swear. Because we're all
right.
Because we're all about the same height. So you'll be towering over us. It's like a convention of small folks with big personalities. but pray for us as we're traveling and for all of our church members who are traveling this summer, that everyone stays safe and healthy. We pray for all of those folks, especially those this week who got vaccinated at our vaccine drive, which was awesome. And we're gonna have other dates on that as well. For those who got sick, we did hear of one child's parent, singular, who tested positive for COVID this week. And so we'll keep that parent in prayer and all of the others as this very aggressive Delta variant is running rampant all over, especially among younger folks and unvaccinated folks. So let us go to God in prayer. Gracious, amazing God, who calls us to trust you, we give you thanks for this day. We give you thanks for answered prayers and new life and health in the lives of those we care for. God, we also give you thanks for this amazing event that we have pulled off in the midst of a pandemic, that we have actually accomplished Vacation Bible School. We have ministered to children and their families and teens, and we have built relationships, and we have laughed, and we have learned, and we have grown comfortable and fond and caring of one another in this week. Thank you, God, that we as a church can provide these ministries for our own community and for the Collinsville community. God, we know how important they are, and thank you for helping us, inspiring us to live into our calling to share your hospitality with all people. Gracious God, we pray for those who are traveling. We pray for those who are experiencing sore arms from getting vaccinated. And we pray for all of those, God, who are still struggling with the coronavirus and its aftermath and are still struggling to find breath. Gracious God, help us bind together as community to share your good news, to share your welcome, and to extend God's love and grace to everyone. And now, God, let us pray. Hear us as we pray the prayer of your Son taught us, when he said, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
During Vacation Bible School, we always have two different offerings for the kids to participate in. And one of them is the monetary offering, of course, where they can bring money in and we support some other mission or ministry. And this year, being out in the wilderness, we decided that we would adopt a few animals from the zoo. And so this year, our kids have adopted the Amur leopard, which is all of the three animals we have gotten are either like almost like critically endangered or they're very vulnerable animals. So, you know, wanting to support them and care for them. Our second animal is the camel, of course, you're out in the wilderness. And our third one is the Nile hippo, being that we were in Egypt, we came from the Nile. Anyways, so we thought if you happen to be going to the zoo, look for the St. John UCC name at those three animals as we have adopted them for the year. So helping to pay for medicines for them and food to feed them and things like that. So if you're at the zoo, check out those animals that we have adopted. Yes, send us a selfie with the zoo animals if you happen to go. Go find them and send us a selfie with them. So then the second offering that we took, the kids collected school supplies, as you can see, or a mound of school supplies up here for Hoyleton Youth and Family Services. So Hoyleton has many different programs, and so some of the children that they work with, they have a residential place for kids to come and live with a whole array of issues or issues with parents. They also deal with foster children. And one of their other big programs that they have is Puentes de Esperanza, which actually, when it began, started here at St. John. Their office was downstairs in what is now the theater. And so we have this connection with Puentes and with Hoyleton. And Puentes works with families who don't speak a whole lot of English. And so they help them to become citizens, to get the things that they need. If they are going to a doctor or a dentist appointment, or parents are trying to talk to teachers, they find interpreters. Because if you're going to the doctor and don't speak the language of the doctor, you can imagine how difficult that would be. And so Puentes tries to help those families make it here and to make the system a little easier to navigate, because those of us who have grown up and speak the language know how difficult our system can be when you're trying to figure something out, right? It's not easy. So we have got school supplies for Hoyleton so that they can hand out to the families so that those children are ready for school to start. If you would like to, so we have already purchased our animals, but if you would like to go to the zoo and adopt an animal, feel free. But we are still looking for more school supplies, or if you would like to make a donation, we can add it to the money that the kids have brought in as well as we give it to Hoyleton. So if you are supporting St. John Church, which we thank you because that makes programs like this possible to reach out to the community and share God's love and remind all of us to trust God. You can also include a little bit for Hoyleton and we will make sure that that gets there as well. And because we want to make sure you see all of the fun that we had this week, we have a slideshow for you to see the children and all of our helpers and the wonderful fun that we had this week.
There are times when we're so afraid, so many years we've lost our way, but we were born to be with the love of us, but God might be the love of us, and we will hold on to your promise. We said, I am your already stand up.
Granted great abundance, let us offer up these blessings in God's name. We thank you for your contributions to St. John for making things like PBS possible. You can donate and drop it in the offering plate in the back of the sanctuary. You can donate on the St. John website, the Give Plus app, and of course, you can always mail in a check later on. So we thank you for your contributions.
I guess that's close. We didn't ask something right there.
I forgot to ask you about the doxology, huh? That's okay.
That's cool. Just imagine you saying doxology.
You know what? I'll do announcements and then you can do days of the life. So, we do have lots of stuff coming up here at St. John's UCC. First of all, I will share that given all of the
incredible youth helpers that were so enthusiastic about being together. Katie Jo and I are planning all kinds of amazing stuff for launching in September. Even before that, though, we've got our Hunger Games event coming up in 2 weeks on Friday night. I'm probably not going in order, but we have August 6th from 6 to 8 p.m. in Faith Hall. We're going to talk about Hunger Games and the Bible and the way in which those two things interact and talk to each other. There are a lot of parallels and really interesting things to learn about both. Also, that weekend, and I won't be here next week or next Sunday, so right when I come back next week on Wednesday night, we're going to have a movie night and watch the Spitfire Grill. We are going to be in the theater, we think, unless, you know, we feel the need in the coming days to social distance, and then we'll figure out and maybe set up in the fellowship hall or something. But we'll be watching this little independent film called The Spitfire Grill, a wonderful introduction to what it means to welcome a stranger. And it's really for all ages. It might be a little, it's a drama, so it might be a little serious for really young kids, but certainly teens and up would find it interesting. And I guess lastly, thank you. To all of our volunteers. We really, really could not have done Vacation Bible School without so many helping hands. Do you want to?
Just, well, thank you. But also today, talking about welcoming people, we are doing cards. The cards that you created.
Yeah, so Miss Dana has created ways for us to live out our mission. And they're just really simple in-house mission opportunities. If you can't go sign up for Habitat for Humanity or spend a Saturday building houses, you can do something right here after church. And Ms. Dana has all our welcome cards, which are an easy outreach method. You can fill it out. It says, we just, you know, you're someone I'd love to begin church with, or something like that. And it's an outreach thing, and you write your name on it, and you write the person's name on it, you pray for them, right? Because that's what we do. And then sometime this week, you hand them the card or mail the card to them, and it's an invitation to come to church. And I think it's just a really simple, amazing way to live out our mission of extending, as in going out into the world, to share God's love and grace. That's the big activity. And I think there are also some care cards over on the table on the other side in the narthex. So we've got folks that are celebrating anniversaries and folks who are not feeling well, things like that. So you can sign your name to some care cards. We've got that ministry ongoing. And we'll see on both tables events. Things that are coming up, things that are on the horizon, and the most recent church newsletter. So, thank you, everyone.
Now for our closing hymn.
Yeah.
Please stand. Let's sing together our closing song, Gates of Life.
Of Elijah declaring the word of the Lord. These are the days of the servant Moses' righteousness in his soul. Though these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and thank you.
Till we meet again.